as possible for all the groups that you name in your call here, plus selected members. And how we do that, I'm very open to ideas and suggestions.
So just to be clear, a fourth option, if there was one, wouldn't be off the table?
No, not at all. If someone wants to suggest an additional option, I'm very happy to consider that.
Thank you.
Would you be open to suggestions and stuff? I'm not having a crystal ball myself. I'm not seeing this report for the libraries. If you had a presentation given to the Labour Party by the company, would it not have been prudent to give us knowledge of that and saying,
no, it's
would
not,
you like to have
no,
it?
Sorry, no, it's, not my, it's not my job to inform the opposition about what information I've given to my group. It's up to your leaders to ask for that information. Shared intelligence said that to do a library mutual and some other authorities has taken up to 2 years from conception to going live, and this proposal here is something far more complex than that. So how long is it going to take? In all that time, there must have been time to start at the beginning by talking to local people to find out what they thought and to find out the input that they could offer.
Thank you very much.
Wendy, you heard the Dean speak about communicating with Baker Squirrels and Great Friends. Do you think yourself or anyone in your position as volunteers are aware of the fact that you would approach that consultation with the
to which I have to say I haven't had an acknowledgement or even a nod that it had been received or read. So I have got no idea what dark hole that particularly went into. I'm not going to read the whole letter out, but I do want to read the core of it to you as my evidence. At the World Parks Forum meeting on the 22nd of March, representatives of 18 separate friends groups were in attendance, and the Phase 1 report was discussed. I had literally picked it off the internet 2 days before, as had people who came to the meeting. They'd only just heard of it, found it on the internet. So, as you can imagine, there was a huge amount of alarm and distress in the actual meeting. Although many members hadn't actually received their own copies via their friends' groups, a quick perusal of the report clearly shows there was no consultation or communication with local friends' groups or with the World Parks Forum per se. We are very sure that representatives from World Council gave information to Bateswell and Braithwaite, but from the perspective of the World Parks Forum and its affiliated friends' groups, no one present on the 22nd of March was aware of any consultation. In fact, most people didn't even know that the report was going to come out, so it was a complete shock to a lot of people there. There appeared to be little acknowledgement within the report of the tremendous work done by local groups in what are rapidly becoming very challenging times to maintain and develop rural parks and open spaces under existing council management. And I have to say that I am receiving some comments from friends groups who are very concerned about the voluntary work they're doing now, as they feel it's recognised, and they are very worried about the money that they are raising to do things for their own parks. And people are beginning to say to me, why are we bothering? So I'm very concerned at this present moment about the loss of good work and the loss of importantly very good work that volunteers groups carry on a day-to-day basis. Now we looked at the report and it did provide various models for discussion, but from our point of view, it actually made a lot of unsubstantiated comments on all the proposed models. There were no references, there was no research presented. I come from a higher education and health service background, so I've gone through years of change management research myself, working with trusts on leadership, change management, communication skills. And so I was looking particularly for the evidence that they were producing in their report, and I couldn't find it. If I did that in the health service, my report would be that because you have to have evidence-based practice. The report didn't actually demonstrate, for example, how local authority training companies are developing, or if indeed they are making the cost savings required of those councils who are currently using such models. Are they providing the new innovative and creative strategies that this report indicates are a requirement for the future? And those same comments apply to the private outsourcing and VENCOMs that were mentioned in the report. Now it's clear that the VWB report supports a new and a different model for the future. It will either be a chargeable company limited by a guarantee or a community interest company limited by shares. But the lack of research, the lack of references displayed in the report is disturbing, and we can only ask that this is a factor that should be addressed during the Cabinet's discussions on the 27th of March 2017, and in all the inevitable future reports that are going to be written. We are not opposed to change per se. We are open to change, and we are very welcome to talk about how our parks and open spaces are going to be managed in the future. But at the moment, none of us understand the models and how they actually work in practice, and does any evidence exist for any of the proposed models? I myself am beginning to start looking online, but now I'm retired, I don't have access to my university databases, so I'm Googling the best I can, but it's not the best way to actually get the detailed information one needs. This report has clearly been written in response to a council request, or was it a tender? We saw no reference to how this report was commissioned or the factors that would ultimately shape the nature of the report. Despite noting phrases such as community engagement or community engagement and voice, the people of Wirral appear to be viewed as passive recipients of the new organisation. There has been no involvement by community interest in the sections relating to parks and open spaces to date, and we are wondering if there will be any involvement during phase two of the council project to highlight very difficult profit generating aspects of its current portfolio.
which appears to make it very plain that there will be consultation.
I think what we're talking about is...
Do you accept the assurance that there will be consultation?
I accept the comments of the leader of the council tonight that there will be consultation, because a lot of you have made it very clear that you would like to see more consultation. At the time of reading that report, which we literally picked up, I picked up the night before, there's a lot in it to absorb, and you have to take on board what people are saying to you, and in time to listen to their views, my letter expressed their particular views. They were very concerned because there hasn't been any consultation to date when the report came out. Who is this company? What are they doing? When were they commissioned? What was the tender? How would we trust that there would be ongoing consultations of friends to this?
Just to follow on, but you do accept that paragraph 8.3 does give the assurance that you appear to be seeking.
I accept it as it's written, but underpinning all those words on that is it has an engagement.
Thank you. Can I just point out that the leader of the council didn't say there was no legal obligation on him to share this report. He said that he's been under no obligation to share with opposition parties. Okay, Councillor Edwards.
In that case, can he share it with anybody other than the opposition party? Other than his own party?
Thank you. Can I get at one point to you, Chair, before I ask Helen Ellis a question? Can we make sure in future that up in the museum we have a sound system so that anybody giving evidence can speak to a microphone? Because I'm sure there are people in the audience who can't hear sometimes. I think it's only fair. I know we've had problems. There's no reflection on you, Chair, as your first meeting. But I think we do need to make sure that we've got a sound system here, probably page in the room as well. It's not beyond our wit to have it to set up some great discipline as well, which we bear that point in future ones.
Okay.
Secondly, can I ask you, Helen, in terms of the email that you referred to, you said on the 22nd when you found that the Cabinet was looking at this issue and you spent the next couple of days drafting an email.
I sent it on Monday morning off the minute.
Right, and you've not had a response to that. Can you recall who you sent that email to, please?
I had sent it, it was Paul Wellington, the secretary of our group, sent it. Because he knows people who he sent it to. I was a brand new chair, literally walked into that as a first meeting. So I wrote the letter, parts for the committee, and he sent it on our behalf.
But you've had no response to it?
No, neither has Paul. I can't personally tell you who we sent it to, but I can give you that information if you want.
Okay, thanks very much. Any more questions? Okay, thank you. Okay, thanks. I would like to invite my Hornby chair friend,
and develop the needs of library communities across the world for the future. Originally, the forum benefited from the independent chairmanship of Professor Robert Lee, and this was extremely useful to us. But unfortunately, of course, due to health, we had to stop doing that. Can I intelligence, because I think this is important. This was a consultancy where various groups were allowed some time to consult with that body, although this was only made possible, as far as I could see, after overcoming quite a few difficulties and a few officers trying to stand in our way. My own friend's group was limited to 1.5 hours, but fortunately I'd submitted a fairly comprehensive briefing paper in advance. When BWB, I can't remember what they really called, BWB was appointed, council officers indicated consultancy time for all. This promise was made meeting after meeting of the forum. But finally, and this was only 6 weeks ago, we were told that there was insufficient time for this to happen. Needless to say, there was general dissatisfaction from all four members. Had I known that the leader of this council was going to announce that there was going to be definite consultancy on the next phase, it might have made a difference. What is interesting is that the forum has a meeting on Wednesday at Wallasey Main Library. And can I put, I'm not sure what I'm asking, but I would ask that either an elected member or a senior officer attends that meeting and explains to the members of the forum just what has been said at this meeting. It would help a great deal. We did ask, for example, if the cabinet member with responsibility for libraries was aware of our concerns, but I never got an answer to that, and I don't think I ever heard that responded to in a positive way by anybody else. I won't go into what we do in my own library, because this has gone on for some time, and I want to hold your attention. I believe that for whatever reasons, community libraries have been denied up till now a right to advance local views, and this would have had a profound effect on BWB's final report. I am relieved to hear that there will be consultation. I have been involved with consultation, which quite honestly is a mockery, and the forum is composed of a number of very knowledgeable fellows, not political people, very knowledgeable fellows of both sexes, I'm okay. And we will get, certainly, we must have some response to that. I've kept it very short because I was going to repeat sort of many things that other people have said, including my good friend, Councillor Sullivan. That is all I have.
What we've done, we've this programme I think has been Stoney's didn't place front and centre was the process, was the fact that residents would be able to, in stage two, take an active part in shaping what the full business case looked like. The stories were about what we were trying to achieve and what we were doing. It wasn't a process, we should have made it, but a little bit more about that. I accept that being the time. In terms of what we will do next, a couple of Phil and the previous Ryland and Councillor Green both referenced Vibrant and Friends organisations and various groups that are involved in these services, and at the rate there's a huge amount of groups that are really dedicated to these services. The stakeholder mapping exercise we've done, which will kind of shape how we consult and how we go out and talk to people. I've got at the moment at the latest count 219 individual groups and organisations that we will talk directly to as part of this work. That will be a range. Sorry, the 219 groups doesn't include individuals who use libraries, tens and thousands. I think at the last count, 14,000 people who are members of what's called Invigorate, which are our leisure centre membership group. It doesn't include football clubs that are on the team on the pitches, it doesn't include bowling clubs, supercuteens, anything like that. All of those we'll get to as well, in either email or letter or some kind of format. But we will be, as depending on the outcome of this evening, we will be getting in touch with all of these organisations and inviting them in to either fill out a survey, either online or paper format, to come in for a presentation or a briefing or to do a focus group or to go to them and have a conversation. It'll be really intensive work, which we would have had done by now, but it will be an intensive 4 or 5 week programme, depending on the outcome of the suit, that we'll be ready to go tomorrow. That's it.
Any questions?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Given that we're going to be doing a lot of these types of reviews, and we're trying to do a lot of different transformation, is there a standard practice about consultation that we always follow? And if there isn't, do you think we should be looking to have some kind of procedure so this doesn't happen in the future?
It's very difficult because it's kind of an apples and oranges discussion, because there's actually legislation that underpins what kind of consultation you should do. So there are for some areas, depending on what the proposal is, we need to do 12 weeks in a specific form of consultation. Where this is different, and where this is where we're moving to for this piece of work. And I go back to what Councillor Green and Councillor Davis were saying earlier on, is that we're not going out to people with a proposal and saying what they think. Yeah, we're not doing that for this. We're actually, our plan is that this will be co-designed, this piece of work. We're actually going out talking to people in a relatively informal way and asking them what they want from the future of these services. What works now, what doesn't work now, where would you like us to improve, where do you think things could be squeezed. It's going to be slightly different, so it's more of an engagement exercise than a formal piece of consultation.
Sorry, when I say process, yeah. Formal process, I mean the whole thing, so the strategy about communication, right. and start to finish. And just one other point to get, so okay. You say it's going to be 4 or 5 weeks.
Yeah.
It's not going to be 4 or 5 weeks over the school holiday, is it? We make sure that it's not inside that period.
Yes, we are at the moment actually through the transformation programme, we are formalising exactly how we do this with everybody's programme. So, but what we will be doing is that we'll always follow exactly the same process, but we'll have to tweak it depending on the audiences, as you would for anything like this. What we're going to do with the consultation programme is that depending on the outcome this evening, we'll start tomorrow and we'll get out soon, because we're going to have to run it over the next 5 weeks basically. We'll make sure that we get out to talk to get information out to school before we come.
You mentioned like touch engagement. What does that actually mean?
Okay. So up to now, we've either shared intelligence or Bell DWB have visited 13 different libraries to talk to people. They've visited one children's centre, two community centres, a range of arts and countryside centres, I'm not sure how many, all leisure centres, the museum and the floor of the building. They've met with friends, groups, volunteers and staff at all of those centres. And the information that they've gathered from those sessions have either been included in the shared intelligence report or the BWB. But I'd say it's fact-finding. It's not going out to ask them about the proposal, it's just asking for general views in this report.
Can I just ask another question, please? Do we still use the compact guidelines that we use with the volunteer community centre to say that we would give 12 weeks consultation?
Yeah,
if things are going to change or for asking for people's opinion, do we still do that?
Wherever possible, we do haven't got to that point where we're putting a proposal for other people to look at. If we get to that point, I think I've made it to October or autumn time when the full business case, then those, that situation will likely apply depending on what the final business case looks like.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, Kevin, for being so frank about how perhaps it could have been better if it had been explained to everybody how about the consultation would be in the second phase. Without putting on the spot for the leader, you think if you haven't been so shy in saying to the other groups that you can share with the consultants, Bates, Wells and Braithwaite, and we've been made aware of that, we could have approached them and had some information off them ourselves, perhaps then we could have communicated to the user groups and the other groups that were involved what was actually going on, and we'd be sat here tonight.
If I could just come back on that briefly, Jim, yeah, I think this is secret. We've promoted this quite extensively all the way across the board, and I think it's within anyone's gift. I mean, the French people should be asking for information, anyone can ask for that information. So those requests could have been made regardless of what our communication is like.
Well, I think requests have been made before the end of the year, so you've heard.
Thank you.
Thanks, Kevin. You've spoken, Kevin, about your engagement plan. Specifically in terms of the communications plan, you have a communications plan in place, do you? Which cabinet member did you liaise with on that?
Well, on that, it was the previous cabinet member.
Right, okay, so that was the councillor plan. Okay. So, in terms of the whatever happens tonight, you're going to communicate on something, and presumably the new cabinet member has not been consulted on that plan? So do you accept, in terms of picking up on what the leader said earlier, in terms of communications tools, we've done better with it, in terms of what you've heard from some of the friends groups who have tried to communicate by emailing, by asking questions and not getting a response, do you think it would, with hindsight, it would be better for the authority to contact those friends groups and user groups that you mentioned, the 219 groups that you referred to say at the beginning, we are appointing BWP, and this is the process, and this is the stage that we could have been consulted at, and would that, in your opinion, have allayed some of the concerns you've heard tonight from some of the witnesses?
Yes, in a way. Yeah. That was the point I was trying to make earlier on, is that we did communicate with these groups. What we didn't do is map on the process part. We didn't do that well enough anyway. Our communications were about what we were trying to achieve and how we were going about doing it. Not specifically about this is our point, actually, but we'll be about the organisation. If that was in there, that was in paragraph 5 rather than paragraph 1. That's what we did. That's the bit that changed.
On the 19th of June, you can say I've been on holiday, on the 19th of June, lots of schools break up the second week in July, but apart from that, a lot of people in the French groups take their holidays before the school holidays because their people will be looking after grandchildren, etc. So, as this thing has had to be held in anyway, I appreciate the calling and we have various other things going on. I'm concerned now, there has been this, I wouldn't call it lack of communication, because when I read the document, it made sense to me what we were doing, and those things don't make sense to me, so you achieved something this time. But I'm concerned that people are feeling fraud. We've heard from the chair of the Friends of the Parks, who still isn't sure that this, that any consultation is going to be genuine. And I would rather that we didn't have any more call-ins or any more misunderstandings. So could we have a longer period? I think that would answer the point that Adam was making.
What I'd say is that witness later on is Mark Smith, who is effectively managing the project plan for this piece of work. There's a detailed project plan with certain dates that we've got to hit to actually deliver this on time. That may really badly affect the project plan. I don't know.
You say you have to make those dates. Why do you have to make those dates? Is it some sort of legal requirement? Because I understood that this wasn't start on the consultation, this was a fact finding again.
The best plan for me, on that one would be to prepare those questions to Mark,
this document and ask me what I want and give me time with my concerned, Kevin, about this time. I know I'm banging on about it, you passed it over to Mark Smith, which is fine, but I am very concerned about the time scale. I appreciate that without the calling, this would have been done and dusted, and it would have been done in a time when before people were all going on their own plans. But given that we have that set of circumstances between now and the end of August, can you tell me exactly how I, as a member of the Friends of Mayor Park, will be told how long I will have and what you're expecting of my group?
Okay, to you, Chair. So, as usual, we'll give us an example. You'll get, we'll be communicating directly with that group. We'll give you the opportunity to actually give us feedback in writing, if you can do the post or online. You'll be then invited to a particular briefing on a particular day, because as you know, we've got 219 groups to try and speak to in 5 weeks. So we'll set up a series of, in the process of setting up a series of different briefings, which you'll be invited to join one or two or three different sessions. If you can't make either of them, there'll be an option for you to get us to do separately for a separate conversation that we'll try and work around you as much as we can.
Right, further question, why would my group
write
back to you before we've heard what you had to say?
There'll be information in the communication.
Okay, thank you.
Sorry, Chair, but can I ask people to speak on one of them? Difficult to hear what's been said.
Okay, thank you.
Script, I think this evening we've had some comprehensive questions and answers, certainly responses from the leader of the council, which have covered many of the strategic and technical issues. So just with your permission, Chair, I'd just like to pick up on just a number of specific points, if that's okay. I think first of all I would like to just pass comment on the use of consultants and that particular aspect of the calling notice, which was mentioned. So, as referred tonight, we did follow a competitive procurement process to appoint Bates Wells Braithwaite to carry out this work for us. Really, just to reiterate, they are nationally recognised experts in the field of developing service models within a social value ethical framework. And as a company, they are one of a growing number of B Corps or benefit corporations.